That's Tommy. The other one is Dickie. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, the wonderful star of our show. And she is that.
Good evening and welcome back. You know, one of the most exciting things about doing a weekly television show is showing up. I mean, is being able to work with some of the people I've always wanted to work with. And tonight, just think, we've got George Maharis. I won't embarrass him by reciting his list of credits, because he can really sing as well as act. What's the, give me a bell note, Mom. The people I want to invite. Why don't you come and join us up tonight? Why don't you really? Let's stop it. I know why I love working with you. You're the only girl singer who sings as loud as I do, opens her mouth as loud as wide as I do.
Well, I don't know. It's because when we sing, we like to get a good breath down there, and the only way you get it is to open up.
That's right. Sometimes I open my mouth so wide, I close my eyes. I can't see the cue.
I know. I had an agent a long time ago when I first came out here to Hollywood who said, I think I'm going to find it a little difficult to book you into movies because you just don't look attractive when you sing. He says, do you have to open your mouth that wide? Can't you just sort of have a little pretty mouth like this?
Peach, like that. Persimmon.
Yeah, peachy persimmon.
How can you sing like that?
But you can. I mean, like, for instance, try to do day in, day out like that.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Day in, day out. Ah, you've cut this open.
I know it.
I think that's what I sort of had in mind for this spot, because they've got the wrong cue cards up and nobody's helping us.
Oh,
do you realize what we did? Well, let's just look at where we're going.
Yeah.
Do you want to start over again now, or shall we do it next week? It can't be done. Look, why don't I first sing so? It's Chinese in there.
Yeah, all right. Where shall we go back to?
I don't know. Let me do a song of yours, all
right?
Because this is a worse retake than it was an original. We were in trouble.
True. And you want to know something?
Why?
That's the way it's got to be
all the time.
Rehearsed it that way, okay?
Right. Now, I wouldn't say cut. I'd just say press.
I think I'll stick to my chatting, don't you?
No, I like that. I really did.
That was very sweet of you. Now, at any rate, I'm going to force you to sing
me
a song.
I've got to tell you about the jacket that I wore for the presentation.
The jacket?
Yes.
Yes?
I wore a jacket because...
When was this?
Well, when I was obese.
Oh, yes, this word again. Fantastic word. Where did you pick that up?
They wrote that about me all the time, and I evidently was. I don't know what it means. If you find out, cable me. But there were jackets. There was a fat lady's jacket maker.
There isn't.
And he sort of covered up all kinds of chins that you might have or might have. And if you wore a proper hat down to here and tucked everything up here, jacket with a mandarin collar down to here, it covered up all kinds of things that people knew about anyway. You know, right? And I think that I tried to do the best I could at the press, but there were a lot of photographers, and at one point somebody said, look over here, and I didn't dare, you know. No, you come over here. But I did drop a menu or something and went, oh, and they got that one. That was the first time I ever sold a million copies, and I've been recording since they had cylinder records, you know, or a speaker and a dog. But I got a real gold record for that one. And we did those concerts all over the country. We did 48 of them, actually. And one of them was at the Hollywood Bowl here in Hollywood. And everything was fine except that it's outside, you see, and it was a rotten night, terrible night. And I had particularly asked them to build a runway over this great big pool of water that, you know, the audience, I mean, is separated by the artist from, by this vast ocean. So they built a runway without any bulbs on it, to confuse me. And it started to rain at the beginning of the overture. And I thought, well, what the heck, you know. But there was, I had to come out with a hand mic like this. And there was about 108 feet of cord in back of me. And just as they finished the overture and I started to come on, the stage manager stopped me and said, now, don't let any of that cord get in the water or you'll be electrocuted. So I went on and I did the dodgiest performance you've ever seen in your, and I wrapped the cord around and just everything, and I said, because I was going to be short of office. Those were the days. And then the first violinist was married to the harpist at the Hollywood Bowl. And he was so worried about her harp that she put her raincoat over her and her harp. And that looked made the whole show look terrible. And then the first violinist walked off with his wife. Oh, it was just a mess. Anyway, I'm glad we played Carnegie Hall and made the album. Let's do that one song that we want to do, shall we, Don? Breaking heart, and I can see that you and I can never be. But with my very best, I set you free. I wish you from a storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, but most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you you free. I wish you shelter from a storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, the most of all, when snowflakes fall.